Hello Internet and welcome to Ever Wonder. Often mentioned but never really explained here, the Coriolis effect finally gets its own video. This effect is not really a force, but rather a motion relative to a rotating frame of reference. Okay, what does that mean? Don't worry, it's not that hard, even if this is my second attempt at a script. So I make it an easier explanation this time around. Let's look at the Earth from above the equator. The planet rotates once a day, but depending on where you are, you need to travel a longer distance at the given time. This means the nearer you get to the equator, the faster you have to move with the rotation. I will indicate that with these arrows. So far, there is no Coriolis effect, even if we rotate the Earth. For that to occur, we need to travel along with the objects on the poles towards the equator. Since these objects are slower than the rest, they will start falling behind. On the other hand, if we move the objects from the equator towards the poles, those are much faster and take the lead. You can see that the northern hemisphere deflects to the right, while the southern hemisphere deflects to the left. This results in a counterclockwise rotation in the north and a clockwise rotation in the south. Pretty easy so far. But what about those arrows? I didn't explain them at all. Well, you're right. I just wanted to get the basic north-south direction out of the way. Let's start with the east-west and the centripetal acceleration, but one step at a time. First, let's look at the Earth from both the poles. In this case, the South Pole. Additionally, I draw some latitude lines. On each of those, an object needs a certain speed for one rotation. At the poles, that speed is zero. And just to keep things simple, each line increases the speed by, let's say, one. Now the centripetal acceleration. This is the velocity needed to keep a moving object within a certain radius. Just think of a chain carousel or a stone on a string. Let's overlay the chain carousel with the southern hemisphere. Once we increase the velocity, we move towards the equator. And if we slow down, we drop back to the pole. I think it's easier to visualize it that way. So if we move together with the rotation of the Earth, we will increase our total velocity and drift towards the equator. But once we start moving west, we will slow down and move towards the pole. And there we have it again. In the southern hemisphere, we deflect to the left, resulting in a clockwise rotation, while the northern hemisphere deflects to the right, of course, with a counterclockwise rotation. Our standard format for hurricanes, ocean currents, and destructive toilet swirls. But the last one only happens under perfect conditions. And with that being said, see you again. Have a good one.